Did you know it has been 227 days since we first felt the effects of COVID here at our parish? And there's a general sense that I'm experiencing, observing, of people just done, just fed up, just tired, sick of wearing masks, tired of visiting people, not being able to visit people they love or go to hospitals, worried and anxious about school and holidays and a whole new second wave. And it's perfect that our readings for today talk about the gift of perseverance. We hear Jesus in our gospel today say, I'm going to do today, tomorrow, and the day after tomorrow what I have been called to do. I'm not going to waver from my path. And in our first reading today from Paul's letter to the Ephesians, we hear about this battle that we're experiencing. And like Paul says, it's not a battle of flesh and blood, but it's a battle of the spirit. And maybe we're experiencing that battle interiorly as we try and grapple with this world in which we're currently living. But Paul gives us some ideas on how to be prepared for this battle. And he goes through a whole outfit of what we are supposed to wear. We hear that we're supposed to put on the belt of truth, the breastplate of righteousness, or let the love of righteousness and justice guard our heart. We're supposed to wear the shoes of the gospel, the shield of faith, the helmet of salvation, and lastly, the only offensive object, the sword of the Spirit, which is the Word of God. How great that God has given us Himself to be our offense. That we realize that what we are going through now and what we go in our daily life is an extension of what Christ has done on the cross. By Christ's death on the cross, He destroyed death forever and it redeemed the world. But we get a share in that redemption right now in the way in which we live, in the way in which we persevere. You know, future generations will look back and ask you, how did you live through this? How did you get through this? I hope we respond with the same way St. Paul ends his letter. Prayer. By praying for each other. By recognizing in prayer that we are not the ones fighting the battle, but Christ is fighting it through us. And that battle begins by first letting Christ conquer our hearts.